Let's introduce our guests on the program today. Let's bring them up on our screen now. Madhavan Narayan, veteran journalist, is on the program with us. Sava Naqvi is also joining us, columnist, commentator, one of our foremost journalists. PKD Nambiar, a policy and political analyst, is with us. And Zafar Sareshwala, an educationist and someone who's, of course, long been championing the cause of his community, is with us as well. So, Nod, PKD, go ahead.
Barka, thank you for having me here. I must tell you, and one thing is very clear, that why do we need to even give this kind of an importance for this kind of a statement which is coming from the RSS chief? RSS stand, not from today, from the day one, has been the same. There is no change. That from 1925 till today, if anybody whomsoever study very well and closely monitor the RSS activities, the stand of RSS has not even changed even for a bit. In fact, the second chief of RSS chief, the Guruji Golwalkar, who was supposed to be the most of the liberal media in India, even today says the Guruji was the most fundamental leader of RSS. On an interview in the 1970, the very famous journalist of that time, the Jalaluddin Gilani, he gave an interview to Mr. Gilani, and in which, on a question when he was asked, and I quote the answer what he, the Guruji had given, Indianization, the question was this: much has been said about the Indianization and a lot of confusion has arisen over it. Could you please tell me how to remove the confusion, which we are talking right now? And I wanted to clear this confusion for once and forever. And the people who generally just come up and once upon a time, again and again, with this confusion. The Guruji then said, Indianization was, of course, the slogan given by Janasangh. Why should there be such confusion? Indianization does not mean converting all people to Hinduism. Hinduism. Please note that, because people often very confused, especially the people who feel that they know everything across every platform, should be very, very carefully noting this. Then he says, let us all realize that we are all the children of this soil, and we must have our allegiance to this land. We belong to the same society that our ancestors are common, or rather, today Mohanji said that we all have the same DNA, that our aspirations are also common.
Then how do we explain?
Is precisely, now I wanted to say, in the 1970, this interview, just give me one second, Barka. 1970, this was the stand of the second chief of RSS chief. Today, even Mohan Bhagwat is not even saying an extra word. So, yeah, you want to say something?
I just want to bring up these images of victims of.
You will always interrupt me. You will never allow me to complete.
No, I'm asking you only. I'm asking you to respond. I'm saying that if this is the philosophy, PKD, then these images you see on the screen, right, from Muhammad Akhlaq to Pehlu Khan to Junaid, and in all of these cases, what's common is not even that they were killed over meat, but that they were killed over a false, or attacked over a falsehood involving meat, right? Not that there was beef, such hota, there was any justification in the violence. How do we explain this mob mania? How do we explain the go to Pakistan trope? How do we explain that Muslim Bollywood actors are held to a different standard than non-Muslims? How do we explain that the recent Pew survey shows that many more Indian Muslims see partition as something that has created a communal environment rather than Hindus? While, of course, there are other findings in the Pew survey which we've discussed, but go ahead.
So it's precisely, this is what Mohanji has explained very well. Those who are a part of a lynching is not, they cannot be even called themselves as a Hindus. A true Hindu will never do that. So taking up one or two incidents or 100 incidents cannot define a society as a whole. In fact, there may be only one society in this world. I'm repeating it. There may be only one society in the world. A Hindu does something wrong, another Hindu will stand up for the other religion then and there. You will be standing up, I will be standing up if something is done wrong by another person from the same community, which you won't find seldom in any other religion across the world. So I think that is the quality of it. And what Mohanji did yesterday or day before is precisely this, that the people who do crime, these are crime. Anybody who do a crime needs to be criticized in its same way, and the law of the land should take the course for it. Now, coming to the one particular
quickly
thing.
Quickly now, I need to go to the others.
No, I haven't come, actually. So the idea is that the people who discuss RSS do not understand how RSS functions. In RSS, for your information, because I was a Bal Swayamsevak in a way from the very early stage of my life. I have been going to I was a Swayamsevak going to a RSS shakas. Let me tell you that in an RSS shakha, Muslims are there, Christians are there. The very well-known people like Justice K.T. Thomas of the Chief Justice, he was the Justice of Supreme Court. What he said about RSS is one of a classic example. The RSS is one of the very major unifying force in India. That is the reason even, let's take RSS in a right spirit, understand RSS before you criticize. This is again, this question itself is irrelevant actually, Barka. This is the reason.
Why? I'll tell you the reason. What Zafar Sarichwala just said, the BJP may not last for the RSS will.
No, I'll tell you the reason, because you don't know about RSS. The reason is that if you don't know anything about a particular organization or an individual, you'll ask questions which may not be relevant into that. So the people who, like what Zafar Bhai said is something like, I agree with him 100%. That is the truth. When a RSS chief gives a statement, which as I said, from the very first day of inception of RSS from 1925 to till today has not changed. You look at any other organization, 95-year organization, tell me one organization across the world which has not changed its stand, consistently the same. So I believe that the people like Zafar Bhai is the one who will lead the way, take things in the positive direction, take it in the right spirit, and think in a better way. So what is happening is, I'll give you one example. Now, there are some people like you, in fact, in the early morning, I was having another debate where it is a political correctiveness. The RSS chief statement should be taken as a political correctness. The other person was telling that it is a dilution of Hindutva. The third section of the people who are from the hardliners, the hardliner Hindu forces, some of the people who may be associated with RSS in some way or the other way, they are very hardliners who says that go to Pakistan kind of a people. They're saying, though, this is further diluting. This is not acceptable. But the people who understands the intellectual, the real Swayamsevaks on the ground understand that for them, every Indian is a Hindu, and that they truly believe in. And I must tell you this.
What does that mean, what you've just said? We're back to square one.
That is what I said initially. I said that there is a civilized, that you look at it, the prism of everything from the religion base. I look at from the prism of a civilizational background. That is Hindu as a civilization. Safar Bhai and me are having the same DNA. And the Sabha Naqvi and me are the same origin. And I don't think we may have. She may be through, different stream. One second, Barka. You are a different stream. I am a different stream. But at the end of the day, we all fall into one place. That is the bigger ocean. I'll tell you that the problem is that we look at RSS from the textbooks or something like from the TV channel perspective. But RSS do not function in that level. Let me tell you this with my own experience. I'm telling you, I'm like almost 44 years. From the last 40 years of associated with as a Swayamsevak, it has never ever, at least to me, it has never ever preached. And I'm coming from a very, very hot, Muslim majority populated area. There is a large number of people who do be a part of Muslims or Christians are a part of RSS. Please understand, then don't create a prism and against Sankh, which is not true. RSS has nothing to do with the election. It always supported. There was time in one of the debate, a very great guy said that there was a time RSS used to support the Congress. So that RSS did not require to be in the politics electoral politics.
Zafar Sarichwala, P.K.D. Nambiar, Sabha Naqvi, Madhavan Narayan, of course, never a dull moment in Indian politics, that's for sure. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you again soon.